Now, the second and most important approach to this problem of scarcity and choice is the production possibility frontier, PPF, a solution to economic problem, a simple graph device called the production possibility frontier, PPF, illustrates the principles of constraint, choice, opportunity cost, and scarcity. The PPF is a graph that shows all the combinations of goods and services that can be produced if all the society's resources are efficiently used with the available technology. Now consider the following figure. On the y-axis, we measure the quantity of capital goods produced. On the x-axis, we measure the quantity of consumer goods. All points below and to the left of the curve represents combinations of capital and consumer goods that are possible for the society given the resources available and existing technology. Points that are above and to the right of the curve, such as point G, represent combinations that cannot be reached. If an economy were to end up at point A on the graph, it would be producing no consumer goods at all. All resources would be used for the production of capital. Similarly, if an economy were to end up at point B, it would be devoting all its resources to the production of consumer goods and none of its resources to the formation of capital. Now, points that are actually on the PPF are points of both resources employment and production efficiently. Resources are not going unused and there is no waste. Points that lie within the frontier but not on the frontier represent either unemployment of resources or production inefficiency. For example, an economy producing at point D can produce more capital goods and more consumer goods by moving to point E. This is possible because resources are not fully employed at point D or are not being used efficiently. Now here the opportunity cost comes again. The PPF illustrates a number of economic concepts. One of the most important is opportunity cost. The opportunity cost of producing more capital goods is fewer consumer goods. Moving from E to F, the number of capital goods increase from 550 to 800, but the number of consumer goods decreases from 1300 to 1000. Suppose what is happening at point D. First, unemployment. During the Great Depression of the 1930s, the US economy experienced prolonged unemployment. Millions of workers found themselves without jobs. In 1993, 25% of the civilian labor force was unemployed. This figure stayed above 14% until 1940. More recently, between the end of 2007 and 2010, the United States lost over 800 million payroll and unemployment rose to over 15 million. Now, second concept which can be drawn from the PPF is inefficiency. Although an economy may be operating with full employment of its land, labor, and capital resources, it may still be operating inside its PPF at a point such as D. It could be using those resources inefficiently. What happens? Sometimes inefficiency results from mismanagement of the economy instead of mismanagement of individual private firms. Suppose, for example, that the land and climate in Andhra Pradesh are best suited for corn production and the land and climate of Punjab are best suited for wheat production. If the government passes a law forcing Andhra Pradesh farmers to plant 50% of their acreage with wheat and Punjab farmers to plant 50% with corn, neither corn nor wheat production will be up to the potential. The economy will be at a point such as A inside the PPF, allowing each state to specialize in producing the crop of that it produces best, increasing the production of both crops and moves the economy to a point such as B. We can see that in the following figure. As we can see above, inefficiency from misallocation of land and farming, that is, society can end up inside its PPF at a point such as A by using its resources inefficiently. If, for example, Andhra Pradesh climate and soil were best suited for corn production and those of Punjab best suited for wheat production, a law enforcing Punjab farmers to produce corn and Andhra Pradesh farmers to produce wheat would result in less of both. In such a case, society must be at point A instead of point B. The law of increasing opportunity cost. The law of increasing opportunity cost can be explained by first explaining the meaning of a negative slope. Negative slope. Now, what is a negative slope? The fact that scarcity exists in the PPF is shown by the negative slope of the PPF. In moving from point E to point F as shown in the PPF figure, capital production increases by 800 minus 550, that is 250 units, a positive change. But that increase in capital can be only achieved by shifting resources out to the production of consumer goods. Thus, in moving from point E to point F, consumer goods production decreases by 1300 minus 1100, that is 200 units, a negative change. Thus, the slope of the curve, the ratio of the change in capital goods to the change in consumer goods, is negative. The value of this slope of the society's PPF is called the marginal rate of transformation, MRT. The MRT between points like E and F is simply the ratio of the change in capital goods, a positive number, to the change in consumer goods, a negative number. Law of increasing opportunity cost. The negative slope of the PPF indicates the trade-off that a society faces between two goods. Let's look at the trade-off between corn and wheat production. As we can see that table 1 shows production possibility schedule for total corn and wheat production in Andhra Pradesh and Punjab. This can be plotted with the help of figure 3, which shows production possibility schedule for total corn and wheat production in Andhra Pradesh and Punjab. Now, in the preceding figure, following conclusions can be drawn out. First, moving from point E to D shows that we can get 100 billions of bushels of corn, that is 400 minus 300, by sacrificing only 50 bushels of wheat, that is 550 minus 500. Again, we can say that we get 2 bushels of corn for every bushel of wheat. However, we are already stretching the ability of the land to produce corn. Therefore, it becomes harder to produce more and the opportunity cost increases. Secondly, now moving from point B to A, we can get only 50 million bushels of corn, 700 minus 650, by sacrificing 100 million bushels of wheat, that is 200 minus 100. For every bushel of wheat, we can now get only half of a bushel of corn. However, if the demand for wheat were to increase substantially and we were to move down and to the right along the PPF, it would become increasingly difficult to produce wheat and the opportunity cost of wheat in terms of corn would increase. This is the law of increasing opportunity cost. Now next come economic growth. An increase in the total output of an economy that occurs when a society acquires new resources or when it learns to produce more using existing resources. New resources may mean a larger labor force or an increased capital stock. The production and use of new machinery and equipment, that is capital, increase workers' productivity. Improved productivity also comes from technological change and innovation, the discovery and application of new, more efficient production techniques. In our next section, we can see the impact of economic growth on the PPF. An economic growth caused due to an increase or growth of resources in the economy may lead to an outward shift in the production possibility frontier. As a result, the economy can produce more of both the goods, that is wheat and corn, at the same time without sacrificing the substitution of resources amongst the two goods. This can also be shown diagrammatically with the following figure. In the above figure, an overall growth of resources enables the economy to produce more. The PPF shifts outward. The PPF shifts outward from AB to UB. As a result, the economy moves from point X to point Z and production of both the goods increases. A similar argument holds if there is an improvement in technology for the production of one of the goods. This can be explained as follows. Now the figure shows impact of improvement in technology on the PPF. Suppose there is an upgradation of technology in the production of corn, which increases the per worker productivity of corn, that is, for a given amount of wheat, the economy can now produce more of corn. If the economy focuses only on wheat production, it can still produce 500 quintals of wheat, as shown by point B. But all other production possibilities frontier may shift outward. The above figure depicts economic growth as a result of technological upgradation of corn production. As shown above, economy moves from point E, 250 quintals of wheat and 500 quintals of corn, to point F, that is 300 quintals of wheat along with 600 quintals of corn. Therefore, as a whole, the economy is better off producing more wheat and corn. Now, the simple reason is, since the technology for corn production has improved, a lesser number of workers will be required to produce initial quantity of corn, and a little more can be constructed towards wheat with an increase in production. Let us see what happens if there is a growth of resources, particularly capital, within a poor and a rich country with the help of the following diagrams as follows, which shows capital growth in poor and rich countries, that is the growth of resources or and technological improvement. The first panel shows the respective positions for a poor country. As there is substantial growth of resources or a technological improvement in the production of both the goods, that is capital and as well as consumption, from the year 1990 to 1995 to 2010, the PPF shift outward consecutively. On the other hand, we can see the same pattern for the rich country, but there is a difference. As above analysis shows, rich countries find it easier than poor countries to devote resources to the production of capital, and the more resources that flow into capital production, the faster rate of economic growth. Thus, the gap between poor and rich countries has grown over time. Now, this can be easily seen in the diameter of the PPF of a poor country as compared to the diameter of a rich country.